In this video, we are going to build chromium hexacarbonyl with GaussView and take advantage of its point group symmetry features to make building the molecule quick and accurate. Begin with a new view window. Next, open the element fragment and choose the chromium atom within the periodic table. Then choose the octahedral chromium fragment from the list at the bottom of the panel. Click the mouse within the view window to add the chromium. We now have chromium with 6 hydrogens in the proper configuration. In order to minimize the work we have to do to get our full molecule, we will use the point group symmetry dialog to impose and maintain the appropriate symmetry for this molecule. First, enable point group symmetry by clicking on the corresponding checkbox. Notice that GaussView detects the current point group, which is octahedral, and that is what we want. We will constrain the molecule to the octahedral point group for all changes we make in the future. Also, turn on track point group symmetry. And then we're done, so close the dialog. Go back to the element fragment panel and select the carbon element and then the divalent carbon fragment. When we click on one hydrogen atom in the view, all 6 carbon fragments are added because GaussView is maintaining the octahedral point group. The carbon atoms are connected to the chromium with single bonds as we want. Our final step is to add the oxygen atoms. Go back to the elements panel and choose the oxygen fragment and then click on any of the open valences. This will add an oxygen atom to each open valence. Notice that when tracking symmetry is enabled, GaussView displays the point group in the footer of the view window. In this case, we can verify that it is octahedral, which is the appropriate symmetry for our molecule. The molecule is now complete, and we can go on to set up and run our Gaussian calculation.